During the summer, people in the town of Yongcheng love to gather together at an ancient stone tablet. It's the most important cultural relic in town and was erected in memory of a Yuan dynasty prince. But today it's the folk performances that draw a huge crowd. Tonight's show will be an old lamp dance. The performers will be using homemade paper lotus flower lamps. As night falls, the sounds of gongs and drums ring loud, signaling the start of the dance. Gao Jinrong is an expert on Dunhuang dance. While collecting research material in the area, Gao noticed that parts of the dance, especially its S-shaped postures, resembled moves depicted in the Dunhuang murals.
It has 柳树盘根，啊，有这个鸭子尾蛋，啊，有那个双拖掌，啊，像这些在敦煌里面都有呈现。
These dancing postures date back to the Northern Dynasty. They're dressed in Turkic fashion and are twisting their waists and swinging their hips, just like the lamp dancers.
So, 就是这个滚灯呢，就说后来很难找到在采访，说它什么时候流传下来的，这个老艺人说他们现在都很难说，很早很久远就流传下来了，所以我觉得这更和我们古代的舞蹈有一定的关系。Having
carried out comparisons and analysis, Gao believes that the lamp dance has a history of around 1500 years. It's a living fossil that's been preserved at Dunhuang. The art of religion derives from life. The musical dances depicted in the Mogao Grottoes generally fall into two categories, heavenly dances and folk dances. Most of the grottoes have both in their murals. Many dances painted between the 6th and 11th century depict specific events. Banquets, weddings, travel and religious ceremonies are common themes. Experts have been pondering for years what inspired such murals.
所有的专家都会承认宗教艺术来自生活，你也不得不承认它是用 宗教这面折光的镜子来反映的生活。
It's hard to fathom that such bleak Buddhist halls have seen many lavish weddings. There are actually 46 wedding scenes from the Tang Dynasty depicted at the Mogao Grottoes. This is the most typical one. The courtyard is crowded with cheerful guests. A dancer is performing in the center of the yard. A five-member musical band accompanies her.Her dancing style looks very much like the green waist dance depicted in a well-known painting of the time.
那个跳舞的人就跟那个绿腰的舞的服装也好，什么舞姿的风格也好，简直就一模一样。
This is another eye-catching scene. The bride is wearing the typical headgear of Uyghur nobles. But the groom is in han attire. A man and woman are singing and dancing. A waiter holds a tray of drinks, ready to serve wine to the guests.
那这就等着去让人喝酒的，就是酒宴上啊，一种娱乐性的舞蹈，比如说。啊，就说轮到某一个人，啊，需要他做跳舞了，那么他啊，就是拿去端起酒杯，啊，他一面跳的时候，那么他跳各种动作，跳到你的跟前，那么就请你一起跳，或者请你喝酒。
Why would wedding ceremonies and banquets be held in Buddhist halls?
那么我们就看到，就中国古代的佛教，它和民间的生活和宫廷的生活，它是有很多关联的，就是在寺院里面，我们知道敦煌的寺院里面的学校，曾经有过很多跟敦煌的贵族的子弟在那儿学习，那么他们同样要学习这些礼仪礼节，那么这些宴乐上的东西，一定是古代礼节方面一个很重要的一个内容。
In Buddhist sutras, it's recorded that people of the Pure Land could live as long as 84,000 years. Women got married when they were 500 years old. The painters depicted Buddhist weddings based on what they saw at real wedding ceremonies. Some of the murals depicted wedding traditions, folk customs, and arts of a bygone era.Today is the birthday of Gautama Buddha, the founder of Buddhism. It's a big day here in Dunhuang. Everyone is offering incense to Buddha. They pray for good weather and good health. The Mogao Grottoes are open to the public on this special day to accommodate worshippers. A large crowd has gathered in front of the 9-story pavilion.
解放前不姓上来的了，坐车来的，吃馍就来的了，都还坐下几天，人都过大上，今天咱都过到4月8的了。
Many singing and dance troupes are setting up their own stages before the big show.
都带着激情前来烧香拜佛，唱响啊！
俗话说得好，就是说生佛面前唱半晌，连头连尾都送掉。啊，男同志唱了呢，身体健康；女同志唱了，长得漂亮。啊，这现在的吉祥话，说明了我们的唱戏的目的就是让佛也高兴，我们也高兴，人民高兴，大家欢乐。
Such joyous, bustling scenes were depicted in murals thousands of years ago. This one was painted at the height of the Tang Dynasty. The dancer is approaching a Buddhist tower with stretched movements. Behind him, six musicians are playing.People close by are enjoying food and drinks. Not far from them, several farmers are working in the fields. Four children are playing in the sand. It seems they're trying to make a Buddhist tower out of sand. During the Tang Dynasty, temples were the most popular places to see a song and dance performance.The art of religious dancing was gradually perfected over the years and eventually became a form of entertainment. During ancient times, the dancers often wore masks and dressed up as animals during performances.
你要讲到舞蹈的起源，实际上它是人类自己自身的身体和心理的需要，真的是为他的生活，为他活下来提供食物什么什么，他要学到那个熊的样子，他要学到马的样子，学到什么样子去接近那个动物。
那么同时呢，他也要就是欲。对自己啊，在狩猎的过程当中和狩猎得胜利了以后啊，要对自表示一种感情的发泄，感情的快乐。那么模仿某些野兽的动作来进行跳，这个在中国古代文献里面记载很多。
In the Pure Land depicted at the Dunhuang murals, one reoccurring figure is a human-faced bird holding a musical instrument.They're known as Kalavinkas, holy birds of Buddhism, who sing the most beautiful songs. They were believed by the ancient Indians to be the patriarchs of music. They walk around the Buddha and Bodhisattvas, as well as bands and dancers. Their pleasant sounds echo in the heavenly palace all day long.
敦煌壁画中的所谓的嘉陵评价形象我考证的结果是唐代鸟歌万岁月的一种形式的再现。为什么呢？嘉陵评价在佛经里面记载的时间很早了，但是从来没见过嘉陵评价究竟什么形象。敦煌壁画中出现这种鸟歌形式的这种乐舞形式是在唐代，而正好鸟歌万岁月的创作时代就是在唐代，所以这个它的出现年代和创作年代正好是吻合的。
More than 800 drums appear in the Mogao Grottoes murals. Dancing to the drum has been popular in China for centuries. Dong Yong Fu keeps a collection of costumes and props that are used in the local drum dance. Almost every family in the village knows how to perform it. Legend has it that the show was created by soldiers from the Western Han Dynasty 2,000 years ago. It's now listed as a National Intangible Cultural Heritage. Young Mun Yuan is one of the performers. The performance takes the audience back to the battlegrounds, where the sounds of war horses and the pounding of drums were earth-shaking. This painting is found in grotto number 156. It records the magnificent scene of military officer Zheng Yi Chao leading his army during the Tang Dynasty with his cavalry at the forefront. Soldiers blow horns and pound drums.
它主要是振奋人心，传承悠远，对于这个古武将士有很大的作用。In
the mid-Tang Dynasty, Dunhuang and the entire Hashi corridor was occupied by an ancient Tibetan kingdom. Although ancient Tibetans were Buddhists, built grottoes and painted murals, their use of slaves was unacceptable to the Han people.
谁家结媳妇儿，出业权是他的。你这汉族人哪里受得了啊？所以他弄不久嘛，站不久嘛，那就是张一朝团结了，甚至包括藏族的奴隶，团结起来就把吐蕃赶回雪山去了。你到那儿去奴隶制吧，你到那儿去。
In 661 AD, Zheng defeated a Tibetan army and reclaimed the lost Ashi Corridor. Grotto number 156 has many murals about Zheng and his family. There's another one depicting his wife on a journey. A team of juggling performers walk in the front as a man carries a long pole on which four children swing and play.
Dunhuang, 咱们这个壁画故事里面，包括也有咱们杂技的一部分，比如杂耍呀、土火啊、喷火呀，这个也有，包括这个投标啊这种，也都壁画里面都有，也是对我也有这样的启发了。下一步咱们就准备把这一部，把这些。
The ancient acrobatic performances seen in the murals are recreated on the big stage by the Gansu Provincial Acrobatics Troupe. Their show, Goddess of Dunhuang, reenacts the amazing acrobatic and dance performances seen in the painting that focuses on Zheng's wife. The performance runs nightly at the Dunhuang Theater. A centuries-old musical score overwhelms and mystifies the entire world. How can it be decoded? Why are the decoded melodies so different from each other? Musician Shi Zheng Guan has devoted his life to bringing ancient Dunhuang music onto the stage. Join us for part 7, Lost Music of the Stone Chamber.